Greetings and welcome to another Trixie-tastic episode of Veronica Explains. I'm Veronica, and it's February 2025, which means we're a few months from the launch of the next Debian edition. In today's video, I'll show you how to install Debian's testing distribution right now, so you can try it out for yourself. But after this, I'll tell you why Debian testing might not be for you. If you just want to snag an ISO to perform a clean install, head to debian.org/devel/debian-installer and grab the ISO that suits your needs. I typically choose the AMD64 Net Installer CD image. Then you install it like any other Debian install. And here what you're really doing is testing the next version of the installer, which happens to be reasonably effective at installing Debian testing. I'm planning a future video called Debian for Absolute Beginners, where I'll go much more in depth on how to install and configure Debian from scratch. So if that's something you want to see, you can subscribe to me via RSS, or if you want to make the mighty algorithm happy, there's apparently some buttons you can click inside YouTube. Have I ever said hit the bell in a video?
Don't do that.
The other, more traditional way to install Debian testing is by modifying an existing Debian stable installation to point to the testing branch instead of the stable branch. The advantage here is that you can upgrade an existing Debian system in place without having to reinstall everything from scratch. Of course, this comes with some serious risks. Like all upgrades, there's a chance that incompatibilities could cause you some headaches. But upgrading to testing adds additional challenges, and in my opinion, isn't well suited to the Debian novice, particularly this far ahead of the release. If this device is important to you, you might want to consider trying it in a virtual machine using the ISO method instead of risking your data. I made a video years ago about running QEMU and KVM, and it still holds up pretty well. So go check that out if you're curious about running VMs. Also, if you have any apt pinning or manually added alternative repos for your Debian box, you might want to look at those to determine if you've got incompatibilities before continuing. But hey, if you're manually adjusting your apt sources already, you probably don't need my help installing testing in the first place. You'll need to open your apt sources list file with root privileges or sudo in order to point your distro at testing. Now, as far as text editors go, I prefer Vim. But considering this is a beginner-friendly explanation, I'm going to use nano. Sudo nano /etc/apt/sources.list. Then you have to update the sources to reflect the new code name instead of the old code name. Right now, in February 2025, Debian Stable is codenamed Bookworm, and that's what my apt sources list uses. Debian Testing is codenamed Trixie, so that's what I need to list here, simply by replacing the word Bookworm with the word Trixie on these four lines. The primary repo and its source, as well as the security repo and its source. Then we should comment out with a number sign the dash updates repositories, since those aren't available to Trixie while it's in testing. Might be worth setting a reminder to add those back in later this year when Trixie is formally released. Lastly, since we're using the nano editor, we press Ctrl X to exit, then Y to save the modified buffer, followed by Enter to simply overwrite the existing file. Now we do a sudo apt update, which shows a large number of packages to update, followed by a sudo apt upgrade to actually install the packages apt is able to get working. Note that you can try a full upgrade, but this will likely remove some packages, and at this stage in the Trixie testing, there's bound to be some problems. I tried it in my footage VM and it completely deleted the Plasma desktop. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Make sure you've tested your backups. Proceeding with the apt upgrade will download a ton of stuff. Expect this to take a while. After apt reads the change logs, you'll likely get a few informational updates about changes made in individual packages between the versions. This is handy, and you can scroll through them if you'd like. And at any time, you can exit this notification with the Q key. Then the process of upgrading your packages will start, and it can take an awfully long time. And at this point in the cycle, it can be a buggy mess. I mean, remember, this is a testing branch and not a rolling release Linux distribution. Users are expected to troubleshoot on their own and report hiccups. If you're interested in helping Debian and not just kicking the tires, you should really familiarize yourself with the bug tracker. And if that doesn't sound like something you want to do, Debian testing is probably not for you. In my case, as I suspected from my testing, Plasma didn't update. I had to drop into console and do some digging around, reinstalling various parts of the desktop until I had something resembling a complete package, which really leads me to the heart of this video. Debian testing isn't for everyone. When Debian formally releases a new version, moving testing into stable and starting the release cycle anew, they do so having done countless hours of troubleshooting and testing of various deployment scenarios. And at that point, your upgrade is much more likely to go reasonably smooth. Installing Debian testing well before it's become stable is a fantastic way to help the Debian team collect information for their eventual release. It can work as a daily distro, but it's not ready for deployment software, and you shouldn't expect an upgrade path that's polished. If you're just trying Debian testing and you don't care about data loss or stability, yeah, go nuts. But if your system is critical for your work or your play, you might want to think twice. Debian testing isn't a rolling release like Arch or Tumbleweed. I mean, lots of folks successfully use it like one, but if you don't know what you're doing, you could be in for a headache. I already did a video talking about Debian and its release cycle, and I'll include a link to Debian's Choosing a Debian Distribution page, because that's kind of helpful. But to offer a simple explanation, Debian Unstable, or SID, is the landing space for new and updated packages into the Debian ecosystem. And after a period of time, those packages trickle into the testing branch, which gets a code name based on a Toy Story character. And as of filming, that code name is Trixie. Testing eventually becomes the stable branch when the release manager decides that the next major version of Debian is ready to come out. And this happens about every 2 years. Before it's released, a series of freezes happen, and new packages are increasingly held from testing to allow the distro to mature and critical bugs to be squashed. For Trixie, we're expecting the freezing to start in March 2025. And sometime after that, the branch codenamed Trixie will go from being quote-unquote testing to quote-unquote stable. And then the entire process begins again. The key thing to remember is that SID users typically get new packages rather quickly, and testing users get them a bit later. And for a lot of us, that's a happy compromise, but it's not without its problems. If the process of testing uncovers a bug that wasn't caught in the unstable branch, the upstream devs will do their darndest to fix the bug. And that bug fix is first released in unstable before going to testing. But if that bug fix release exposes more problems, the new package might be held up from testing while they continue to work on it. And this can result in a buggy experience that doesn't see a resolution for a longer period of time. It can also mean that upgrading to testing mid-release could cause you some headaches. Like your desktop not getting an update because one programmer dependency was held up. For this reason, plus the fact that security patches for testing typically lag behind unstable, some folks recommend against using testing if you want an up-to-date yet functional distro. And my general recommendation is that unless you're planning on contributing feedback or code to Debian, it's probably best that you stick with stable. And if you want a distro that releases updates more often than about every 2 years, Debian really isn't what I'm going to recommend. In fact, I can already hear the comments. But Veronica, why does Debian have to update so slowly? Well, the answer to this is pretty simple. Your needs and my needs aren't the same, and Debian's fine for me. I've used Debian as my primary desktop distro for the entire bookworm cycle, and I couldn't be happier with it. Trixie's aiming to be rocking GNOME 48 as well as Plasma 6 dot something, and I'm confident it's going to be an excellent choice for someone looking for a more laid-back approach to Linux. If you care more about getting work done than chasing the flashiest trends on Reddit, Debian's a choice that's worth looking at. If you want something that moves a lot faster, Arch, Tumbleweed, and Fedora are right there. But that's really the great thing about Linux. We have a ton of reasonable choices to fit every type of computer user, because Linux is awesome, and so are you. If you're still watching, comment, "It's Tangara time," and then go watch the Veronica Explains Nothing video where I unbox this thing.